So what's the best way to record gaming videos on your computer? Well, you want a good capture program. You want something that's free, high quality, and easy to use. And today, I'm going to be going over just that for complete beginners. I'm going to show you exactly how to find the program, how to install it, how to set it up, and how to use it. Stay tuned. G'day, my name's Marcus. I'm a video game and YouTube enthusiast. And today, we're going to be talking about OBS, which is an awesome screen recorder you can use to record your video games for free. Now, I think pretty much every man and his dog has made one of these videos. However, I want Grow Your Gaming Channel to be a one-stop shop for you guys, so I can't claim to be a channel that teaches you how to create gaming videos without showing you how to physically create gaming videos. So I'm going to show you step by step exactly how to download OBS, set it up, and use it. Let's get right into this. So first, let's come over to Google and type in OBS. You want to click on Open Broadcast Software, the obsproject.com. You'll be sent straight to a page like this, and you can select whatever operating system you want OBS on. Now all we have to do is wait for it to download, and then we can start setting up the program itself. In most cases, the installer will automatically be sent to your Downloads tab, unless you specified otherwise. Now you're going to have to wait a little bit before you can actually install it, but I'm a very intelligent person, so here's an installer I prepared earlier. Just double click on it, click yes, and just follow through with the steps. On that little wizard, all you're going to have to do is click next, you're going to have to accept their terms and conditions, you're going to want to hit next again, and then you're going to hit install. Following that, OBS will install. It should also install a desktop icon that looks like this. If not, you can go to your computer's search bar and search for it. Select it, and a page like this should come up. This is the OBS UI. We'll get into actually creating scenes and sources to record stuff later. However, for now, let's develop a foundation and get our settings right. So I'm going to come over here to the bottom right and click on settings. In general, we don't really need to change anything. Two main important things are language. Obviously, you want a language you can understand. And second is theme. So theme, I prefer the dark theme, which is what we're using now, but you have a couple of options if you really hate this one. We're going to skip over stream because we're not streaming. However, if you do want to live stream at some stage, you can connect your stream account here. Next, we have output. And you'll notice this little drop-down bar up here for me is grayed out and it says advanced. Yours is going to say simple because it's on the default settings and it's not going to be grayed out. So you need to click on that and select advanced. Once you've done that, come across to this recording tab like I just did. And now we can get into the actual good stuff. So first, just set type to standard. Second, your recording path. This is where your videos are going to be saved to. If you want your raw OBS recordings to be sent to a specific folder, click browse and then select the folder. Now we want to come down to recording format. Select MP4 from the options. Next, it's audio tracks. Automatically, it should have a check mark over the one, but we're going to go ahead and check number two as well. Leave 3, 4, 5, and 6 unchecked for now. Next, we have the encoder. This is probably the most complicated part because it's different for everyone, depending on what graphics card you're using. If you're using a NVIDIA graphics card, you should see a NVIDIA NV Inc. with a bunch of numbers and in brackets new at the end. Select that option. If you're using an AMD graphics card, you should see something similar, but instead of saying NVIDIA at the start, it's going to say AMD. If you're using neither, you won't see the NVIDIA or AMD options, so just leave it on default. Next, come down here to rate control and select VBR. Following that, we have the bitrate and max bitrate, and this depends on your computer's speed. If you have a fast computer, set your bitrate to 40,000 and your max bitrate to 70,000. However, if you have a slower computer, set your bitrate to 30,000 and your max bitrate to 50,000. Keyframe intervals, we're going to set that to 2. For the preset, if we have a slower computer, you're going to want to use performance, and if you have a faster computer, you're going to want to use max quality. As profile, you're going to want to select the high option. Make sure look ahead and psycho visual training are selected. You can leave GPU at 0 and set max B frames to 2. Following that, we can hit apply. Now we're finished with output, so let's move on to audio. Leave your sample rate at default. For channels, select stereo. Leave your desktop audio device at default. Disable your second desktop audio device. And for mic, select the microphone you're going to be using. You can then disable the other three microphone options. After changing anything, remember you always have to hit apply. Next, let's come down to video. You want to make sure your base and output resolutions are at 1920 by 1080. And the next thing we've got to set is our frames per second. If you have a slow computer, set your frames per second at 30. However, if you have a faster computer, you can set your frames per second to 60. Remember to hit apply after changing everything. We can skip the hotkeys tab and go right to advanced. Set your process priority to above normal. And you can leave all the rest of the settings on default. You can now click OK and congratulations, you've finished setting up OBS. So now to actually record something, we need to add a scene. Think of a scene as like a setup. For different games and different times, you may want to do different things. For example, if I'm recording cinematic footage, I don't want to be recording my microphone. However, when I'm recording a commentary, I want my microphone to be recording. So I'm going to set up two separate scenes for that. I'm going to show you how to set up a scene right now. First, come over to hit the scene thing and click on the plus icon. Let's name it Com for commentary. Now we're in our scene, you can see our sources have been left blank. Next, we need to add a source, because at the moment, we're capturing absolutely nothing. So let's come down here, click on the plus icon, and we want to click Display Capture. You can rename it if you want to, but that's not necessary. Hit OK. And as you can see, just like magic, this lovely little box has come up, which is now showing us live that our screen is being captured. If you want to capture your cursor, obviously leave this ticked. If not, you can untick it, but that's pretty much it. Hit OK. And here we are capturing our screen. You can also see over here in the mixer that we're capturing our mic audio automatically. You can see when I talk, these sound bars are going up and down. You'll also notice that desktop audio is not moving up and down. That's because nothing is currently playing. So I'm going to go over here and quickly play a YouTube video. And now you can see desktop audio. And now you can see the levels on the desktop audio are moving. So now everything is set up. All we have to do to start recording is come over here and press start recording. Obviously, I'm recording at the moment, so I can't do that. However, all you have to do is click start recording, and when you want to stop recording, you just hit stop recording, and you'll get a live demonstration of that in a second. But until then, thanks a lot for watching. I had so much trouble setting up OBS when I was first starting. I actually completely ditched it and bought a bunch of programs. Now I'm back at OBS even after using programs that were actually paid for. It's a really great program, but it can be a bit confusing. So make sure you just go through and follow everything that I did step by step. If you know a friend or someone you think could benefit from this tutorial, feel free to share this video with them because I'm sure they'd appreciate you thinking of them. My name's Marcus, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later. Ready for the live demonstration? Ooh.